Hello everyone, my name is JBR and welcome back to Tiny Tina's Wonderlands. So we're doing another side mission, which should get us to level 17. This is a terrible idea. So we're doing a side mission or two, just trying to get to level 17, and then we're gonna go back to the main mission. Alright. Weird to have a random flamethrower and... Oh, yes, I did kind of destroy all these places and... I'm already on fire. A little more is not gonna hurt. So clear the ways and kill these things. Alright, lead, feed to pen, smack sheep. So. This pen? Hey, I will smack you again. I'll do it again. Oh, never mind.
Yeah.
get to the pen. Now, if you attack me,
you have shown wisdom, kindness, and cunning far beyond your peers, traveler. Take this scale to remember me, as I shall never forget you.
I'm just getting started.
All right, cool. But that was nowhere near getting me to level up. Now I am old and strong. Oh man, that's funny. So it ups my gun damage, increase fire damage. Just in case I soon figure out how to place a second ring upon my hand. Alright, so now we need a new quest. Are there any here? Alright, Ballad of Bones, I think is the one. Alright, that's the main one. Anything else here? What's this? Inner Daemons. That's Return to Brighthoof. A small favor I don't want to do. Ron Riviette. That was something I can do here. If I mess this up, I get skeletons. I'm not here. I just noticed it's called Murder Church. I'm just passing through, guys. Don't mind me.
Stability of the region.
You trouble yourself overmuch with a mundane, my friend. This is a quest for love. Now, quickly to the Cyclops Lair. And always remember to take the scenic route. Life's too short, fire! This one-eyed fiend holds my beauty captive. Who knows how many brave souls have died by its hand trying to rescue her as we do now.
trying to figure out if this is Ron Revote. If it's supposed to be like a Romeo and Juliet story. I just can't figure out what the source for this. Because this looks like Rapunzel's tower. Yeah, that looks about right. Idiot. Him.
Where's the Cyclops?
You don't see the giant with one eye? He's right in front of you, girl!
The clock?
Oh, wait. Does this guy think the clock tower with one eye is a Cyclops? And we're just going along with it? I mean, he needs help, like professionally.
That makes a... That explains why he's just swinging his sword at the tower. And... I mean, I like it. I think this is great. Come. Come, Ron.
Oh, misery. Thy name is Revote. The Cyclops jawed me with some foul eye. I can scarce go on, but... I hear the princess cry! Press on without me! Find the princess!
That keening wail, it can only be true terror! I must hurry! Get the sneak again now!
I did not mean to click that. Wait a second. Is this steam pipe or what he's...
Short than I expected, but who am I to judge?
Alright, return to Ron. I don't know. Am I confused? Yes. Am I gonna give this guy this princess doll? Also, yes.
My heart swells to know my love is near. Have you brought me my sweet, sweet daffodil?
She is indeed lovely. I think. I don't really understand what others find pleasing.
My squire, you must be quite blind to think this common made a princess. Meaning no offense, madam. The princess has the tall and straight back bearing of royalty. The slim silhouette of noble refinement and has long blonde hair, straight as a quiver of golden arrows. Quickly, quickly, pocket the real princess.
What it? Oh. Yeah, this makes sense. He treats objects like women.
This one fits a strange, nice description. Come along, princess. We mustn't tarry.
Squire, where are you? I feel my heartstrings tag. Which can only mean you have the princess.
I don't
know. Of course,
know.
Not a bristle out of place.
Ah, now that we are reunited, our quest nears its end. But what's this? It seems the Cyclops is up, and is none too pleased with us. He summons his horticultural horde. Come, squire, to arms! Darling princess, in the scant few hours we departed, I bring you a dozen points. Again, allow me to spill forth a lyric of five that I might express my overflowing affection before it drowns me. You know, when I tripped on a rock and fall at you, we burst like the apple. So sweet, I humbled my step. Slipped me and tripped me.
Wait, did he say you slipped me and tripped me? Oh. Sorry, I thought he said she's sweet. Shoot, not a shrewmaner.
I mean, I'm gonna let him go.
A new varnish, no? No. You trim your bristles, have you not? Whatever it is, I must say, quite a
story, huh?
Looking at you now, I find myself transfixed by your rapturous gaze. Ah, let us bask here in the pool of love shared silence for what trite poetry could hope to capture the quiet beating.
Come on, Ron. Okay.
Don't just stand there. Adventure awaits. Adventure and a princess.
And I never keep a princess waiting, huh?
All right, and we're free. If you take this dumb bridge and die, I'm gonna be pissed at you. Okay.
Squire, your quest is complete. And yet, I confess, ours is just beginning.
That's a weird way to carry your princess.
Remember all I've taught you, and you shall go far. This world is full of adventures. You only keep your eyes and your heart ever open to his wonder. Now, bid me adieu, fair squire. I must away with his swiftness. I'd never keep a princess waiting after all.
Perhaps I misjudged you. I've learned much in my short time squiring for you. Fare thee well, Ron.
All right.
All right. Although in retrospect, I don't see how he could be.
All right. Let's see. Did we get any good items here? Or did I just help some guy, like, end himself? Why can't I... Increase bravery against the large enemies. Alright. Alright, so take me to the overworld. Because I'm basically gonna hit level 17 once. Is this thing still active? Let me in. Gorge to shallows. There's no water anymore. It's all shallows. Or just land.
Welcome home, my little hellhole.
And so the idiots continued their long, pointless quest, traipsing through the wasteland they made, crushing priceless coral reefs under their boots.
The exposed seabed reveals its hidden treasures. There was a lot of junk.
Flotsam? Are you sure it's not jetsam?
Flotsam is stuff that fell off. Jetsam is stuff that got thrown off.
Huh. I don't even have a snappy comeback. That's just interesting.
Sometimes learning can be fun.
Do you see the destruction she leaves in her wake? A wasteland of broken toys, wondering why their creator has forsaken them. But I guess it's all just set dressing to you, Fate Maker. You keep doing you. If only you could ask all the fish you just vaporized if they feel brought together by fate.
I mean, I just punched some fish to death, so. So I guess I'm not a big friend of the fish. Yeah, I think that other one's a lot better than that one. Oh, those were the same? Alright, let's go. I know it would take, like, some other massive attack of against the ocean to make something like this happen, but this would be kind of cool to see. That was pointless. Whoops. Goodies. 16, not bad. I mean, it did level me up, so that's great. And it leveled me up just in time to fight things, so. Increased elemental. Reflect damage. I'm excited to get that maxed out. Oh, there he is.
I've got the juice! Now we're cooking!
A gate bars your way, and a gentleman stands just before it. A gentleman wearing a pirate hat.
Okay, cutscene. Cool.
Oh, but he's not just any pirate.
He's a skeleton pirate!
Awesome. Bones, 3 wood. Is this like...
No. Hey, he is not a bad oak. He's a good boy. He's a special boy.
Monkey Island.
I'll be the judge of that.
Oh, I thought he'd just start talking.
Avast! I require passage through this gate.
Aye, you'd be wanting to just waltz right through the gates of the briny shell, Margie. Would you be speaking to Bones, 3 wood? First protector of the southern gate, and I say, sure.
Ah, how suspiciously uncomplicated.
Of course it'll do ye no good. The Nerpin Gate is guarded by a vengeful, murderous, gorgeous buccaneer known as Chartreuse LeChance. He'll never let you through. But unless, would you be willing to help me on a quest?
Oh, pirate quest! It's a pirate quest!
Skeleton now, pirate quest.
Do you want to go on the pirate quest?
Oh, I really do!
Ha-ha! Welcome to the crew! There'll be no pirate quest for the Polly, the faithful Vermunculus. A terrible fate befell her, and we may need to put our pieces back together.
Is this you, Bones? Alright, so we're reassembling.
The sea wargs are restless since the ocean were obliterated. You don't want to run afoul of Moldy Dick, biter of crews, scourge of salt and sand.
Friendly advice. That pirate you're throwing
also that
doesn't have a
dogfish. Pretty sure that's just a shark.
Bullets beyond counting.
A dog shark. Or is a dog, is the dog shark a real thing?
Yeah.
Is it a thunder eater? Well, let's see. Okay, he's just... That's right. He's only resistant to thunder. Alright. Let's go... Okay, that's a new dogfish. I was like, I thought I killed you. Ooh, a purple mace.
Casting spells and loading shells.
I would have so many questions about how these sharks developed legs in like no time if they weren't so cool. Oh, because I got caught and couldn't jump. Come on. Ah, shoot. I got caught on one of those little boards. Man. How far back does this take me? This is like right where I met. Man, but now that one's gonna be fully healed. Not how I get up there. Ooh. Just ignore me. Don't mind me. I'm not doing nothing. Is this a... Can I use this? Yes. Hold on to something. Bad time to reload. I'm assuming that's going to launch me over to one of the poly parts.
Oh, that'd be Polly's eye patch. Paradoxically, it helps you see where to go. Electrocute!
Okay, this is not how you use a ladder.
Back on the menu.
Not bad. I mean, not as good as my kills, but not bad. Nothing up my sleeves.
All right, Polly flappers.
Those be the navigational flappers. Keeps Polly high in the air to spot sails on what used to be the horizon.
Alright, so now we just need a squawker.
Now crack some pipe. We need that squawker.
Oh, wow, that did a lot of damage. Is that what's over there attacking me? Oh no, that's a creature. Yeah, well, that's not. Yeah.
These hands are ready for blasting.
Oh, it's just wait. Yeah. Woo! That thing was speeding. Try to clear out all these before I summon a Moby Dick of enemies. Reminds me, I think However, right, this is a new, better mace. Mobley. Mobley, come over near this explosive barrel. All Jaws style. Jeez, that is some flapping.
Polly's back from the dead!
What use is this bird to us?
Polly's me navigator. If we're to take on LeChance and open the Nerfin gate,
LeChance.
It's the help of me former crew. Now sniff him out, Polly!
Sniff him out! Sniff him out!
Chartreuse LeChance ain't just a mighty pipe. He's unkillable. There's a rare curse upon his crew. Tis known as plot armor. I know it well, for it be the same curse I bear. We'll be needing more than guns and ships to defeat him. But we can't go dry or the songs are gonna.
Frogs say it don't taste good. But we tried all day in the same silly way.
I don't want to interrupt this.
A grog like Brown's of urgent soda.
We say it tastes like food.
Aye, that be me first mate and his fellow. They'll never listen to you if you don't start a fight with them first. Challenge him to a duel.
What if we tried to kill each other? Wouldn't that be fun?
Hear that, lads? The hero wants to fight. Wouldn't be a fair fight for ye. See, we've got plot armor. Plus me grogmug's still full of strictly non-alcoholic brew. Amscray.
Okay, so how do we get this guy to fight?
Easy. Pirate rule 27B. Spill grog must be avenged. Break his mug.
Makes sense.
Yeah. You've run afoul of pirate rule 27B. Now that's a serious breach of decorum! You're trying to pick a fight with a sailor?
That is exactly what I am trying to do.
Why should I? I make you fight like a dairy farmer.
And you fight like a cow.
Wait, why are we gasping?
Because you've just been challenged to a duel?
It's the pirate way. Now we gotta hit him with the cuttingest, meanest, wake up in a cold sweat 20 years later is comeback, or we lose the duel. We're gonna need options.
Your mom should have thrown you away and kept the stork.
No one talks about Deborah first mate like that. You're getting killed all.
Oh, I wanted to read them all before making a decision. Man, you can really hear that guy's, like, lips and mouth making that blubbering noise.
I'm just getting started.
Of that skeleton.
Yeah.
this way. Yeet me to Plunder Port.
Before the ocean got a boo-boo blasted, Plunder Port was a small island pirate town. From your vantage point on the seashore, it is a
sky. A whole town of pirates?
I love this.
Why are you so like a pirate?
They're just so free. You know, they take their ships from port to port, answering to no one, searching for fortune and infamy.
Isn't that exactly what we do, just in space?
Space pirates. Whoa.
I think we lost them.
I feel like pirates would be one of the weakest enemies we've fought so far. Next pirates recruit. Oh, we still have to get to the plunder port. Boop, 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 boop. And a two. I mean, actually, those two items didn't look that bad. I don't really know where I'm going. I feel like that could be an issue in the rest of this. Alright, that's not activated yet. So this must be Plunder Port. Someone has red eye. Last one. All right, now, unfortunately, I think my inventory is full. Oh, I got six of these. I can.
Sweet.
you say LeChance? Did you fucking say LeChance?
It's thanks to him me and Copy here look like this. We won't be joining you. The chances are coming now, so you better be on your way. Copy, back to the song.
Oh, what will we do?
They've thrown in with LeChance?
That's right.
Pirate Rule 81D. If a balloon be popped, the popper must be dropped.
Aw, look at you.
Who cares about some stupid toy balloons? Tis a dire day when the pirate rules be ignored. We need to be getting their attention for real. Up the Liberator's balloon.
Home and wanted, we say. Home and wanted, we say.
Oh. Stop shooting me, you stupid turret. Why is this turret? I'm dying. This fucking turret. Stop shooting me. Swabby, you're still alive.
That's it! I'm coming in!
The world is hard to burn!
Guys, just to... Turn off that stupid turret. Just ignore me dying.
Resurrection.
We've gotten to know each other pretty well in the last few minutes. So here be the tale of woe that brought me down to the depths of what used to be the ocean.
Hell yes. Pirate backstory.
Great, I'm just gonna tune out for a minute.
I was the fiercest pirate captain on the buttery seas. I had a fine ship, a loyal crew, and true love. But I lost it all.
Wait, that's it? You didn't even explain the curse.
Oh, so me pirate backstory be insufficient for ye. Never mind then, ye scurvy cur.
Ha! See? She's got nothing. She always forgets to drop character voice when she's scrambling for a decent motivation.
Alright, I think we are about all out of time, so we are going to have to, we'll have to get the rest of this pirate crew all together in the next episode. So, thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to come back next time for more Tiny Tina's Wonderlands. As always, I will see you next episode. Bye-bye.